Hello, welcome to my internship video. I did my internship at Archbishop MC O'Neill Catholic High School in Regina, Saskatchewan. Overall, it was a great experience and I wouldn't trade it for the world. I ended up teaching actually four classes, Phys Ed 9, which was a female class, a Phys Ed 20 and a Phys Ed 30. Both of those were active for life stream, and then also a Sports Med 20. I really taught the Phys Ed 20 and 30 basically throughout my whole time at the school while picking up the other two classes later on. Basically, this whole experience led me to build up my educational philosophy, which basically is that you need a bond of mutual respect between yourself and the students. That means that you have to respect them as people, who they are, their own backgrounds, so on and so forth. They have to respect you, whether it be for your knowledge, for the relationships you build with them, and so on and so forth. If that bond of respect isn't there, then they're not going to learn from you and you won't be able to teach them as you should be able to. Building off of that mutual respect, that's how I really encourage safety in my classrooms and classroom management. So classroom management wise, if a student respects you and you're able to honestly tell them, hey, you're goofing off, you need to calm back down, you need to focus in on the class, they'll listen to you. If they don't respect you, they're going to be like, whatever, and they'll keep on doing it. And that really leads to more issues in the problem. So if you can build those relationships early on and start solidifying them, then your classroom management is going to be easy. When it came to safety, I really focused in on TPSR, so teaching personal and social responsibility. What that really is your students kind of take the lead on a cleanup setup, building relationships with each other, really staying on task, so on and so forth. And you start off with little tasks, little by little, and you start growing that to the point where they can walk into the gym or wherever your class is and start being productive. Really, this also talks about their social responsibility, not to be, let's say, whipping balls around at each other and looking out for each other overall as a whole. And it's really something that transfers into the real world. And I love having that incorporated into my classes. When it came to adaptations in the classroom or the gymnasium, it was very, very everyday thing. In phys ed, you always have students at different skill levels, different levels of physical literacy, and you have to modify your activity so that your students are challenged enough, but they're not left behind in the dust, because if they don't feel like they can do it, then they won't. Even remembering that we have students that are super skilled, so even that giving them an extra little challenge, maybe try doing it with only one hand instead of two, try doing it with your eyes closed, so on and so forth. But when it comes to in the classroom, we also can do these adaptations, either for learning or behavior. For behavior, in my Sports Med 20 class, I had one student who was always asking a bunch of questions that wasn't really relevant to the course material. So what I ended up doing was actually getting a box and gave her the box and told her to write down any questions that she had and put it in the box, and I'll answer them at a later time. And so she took the first 5 minutes or so, started writing all the questions out. And then after 5 minutes of doing that, she'd be on task and really, really into the lessons and not really a distraction for herself or anybody else in the class. When it came to instructional strategies, I followed a handful, just basic ones. So of course, you're going to have direct teaching, which is follow my lead, where you demonstrate the drill, have them follow along with the steps, and then get them to practice it. There's also the feedback, where you're roaming around, you're helping students, you're giving feedback while they're performing the skill. So whether that be questions for deeper understanding, getting them to break down the skill into smaller parts so that they can work on it. Another one is getting them to kind of break down their steps by themselves. So get them to break it down into different performance cues and then figure out what they're doing proficiently in the skill and what they need to work on a little bit more. Another one is kind of giving them a problem to solve, not giving them the answer, just giving them a problem where they have to work through, use their problem solving skills to solve this scenario, which really works on their team leadership, social skills, which ties back into the TPSR. Another one I really like to use is jigsaw learning. So they would learn something, just like in this dance, they would learn their own dance. And then what they did after that is they would actually teach
teach it to their class. So they would have to use performance cues. They would have to break it down into the simple things, just like a physical educator would have to do every single day of, or every single class they do each. Outside of just teaching, I also was very involved around the school. I coached volleyball, the junior boys volleyball team, right at the beginning of the school year, which was an amazing experience. I went traded for the world. On top of that, I also coached the rec curling team. Again, amazing kids, absolutely loved it. And then I also chaperoned the school dance, which here it is. It was really something that I never experienced, and it was amazing.
Mr. Jensen's a really good teacher because he puts a lot of effort and work into his lessons, but he's also always engaging with us and doing it with us and to make sure that we're always having fun.
For the time we've had him, he's been a good teacher. He's a funny guy, but also strict when he has to be. He's very thorough. He makes sure we're getting to work on time. And he's a good teacher and a good guy.
Mr. Jensen is an outstanding teacher, and he has made a connection with all of the students that he has taught at his time at O'Neill. He is a type of teacher that makes class fun, but does also get all the work done. He makes students excited to go to class, and he is one of the best teachers I have had throughout the year.
All right, but yeah, so basically Mr. Jensen wanted me to make this video, so I'm making it. So basically, this guy is actually a really good intern, man. I thought so since day one. Super confident in, like, I don't know why the lighting's so bad. Super confident in, like, what he's teaching. And, like, he knows what he's doing. Like, seriously, like, he explains, like, freaking how different sports are, how they affect different components of, like, fitness and stuff like that. So, like, I don't know, an example would be, like, basically how bowling is good for your body and what it works out and all that stuff. Like, just things like that. It's like, I don't know. He's a really good teacher. He knows how to handle kids. Like, we're in grade 12. He did a really good job with us. And we were a small class, but I've seen him handle other people. And everyone seems to love Mr. Jensen in our school. I don't know anyone who doesn't like him. So that's awesome. If there's anything I can do, this guy's got to pass, bro, because he's, like, super good. There's a lot of interns that are shy and they don't really know what they're doing. But seriously, he could be a teacher today, honestly. So... yeah, I don't really know what else to say. He's